here, let's say hello, YouTube, and say hi. We have a game, folks. I hope everybody is doing well. We can access the Steam community while playing. We're on floor 27. We are at about a, what I call kind of a metropolis. We have 45,000 gold. We've mapped 20,000 tiles. That's a lot of tiles we've mapped, folks. You're in the undulating sands. You explored about half of this, about a third of this floor. It's going to be a little more of a low-key stream today. We're going to, I think if we can get down to what I expect is the third teleporter and then drop back for the character on this floor. I think that'll be good. What do I want to do here? You know what? I think this will still work. And, right, the random one. That was not great, that's fine, that'll work out. Okay. There we go. Alright, good win. I'm gonna turn this down a bit on my end. There we go. Alright, 72 experience. Hey, Radovich levels up, nice. Alright, it's cool. Let's continue to all this. Which way do I want to go here? We'll go this way. See if this all connects back here, which it does. Excellent. Battle 93, you say? Okay. Don't like that. I have to go over there and... Oh, that is mostly completely blocked off. Okay, wonderful. I don't know why I didn't... Oh, because I was trying to just explore and see if I could find what I called the metropolis, and as it turned out, I could. Okay, so don't like that so much. Grab these, and then from there we will come up here, and we'll go back down. That will hopefully move that out of the way. There we go. Nice, easy game. It's easy. Also, I don't know why I didn't grab these. I think again because I was so concerned with. It was either because there was a battle 93 here before, or because I was so concerned with trying to get the other stuff that I just didn't bother. Malar, let's get rid of the stalker. Alright, Malaflux is fine. I can live with that. Actually, I don't think it really mattered if I weren't physical or magic there. I guess just to avoid Nalperno's, if you like to gamble, I tell you, I'm your woman, gun there. Probably worth getting, not that. But, I thought I saw a random single square that I hadn't done over here. Maybe I grabbed it already. The undulating sands, actually kind of annoying for figuring out what you have and haven't done yet, not gonna lie. Okay, I think we're alright though. And yes, I understand they are undulating sands, so that is probably at least partially by design, but, you know. Just gonna take them out. Yes, it should. Because Elva will get the plus 200 damage, so we'll be good. Hey, Manazar gained a level. Nice. Oh wow, it was like 200 additional hit points. Really cool. Alright, so I can just shift over here. Whoop. Is this one the Adventurer's Rest? Yes. Okay. And then just for the heck of it, we'll heal as well. Okay, very good. Let's do some more filling in of squares, shall we? I'm sure there's some kind of, like, almost traveling salesman type of problem here. You can try to figure out, like, what's the quickest way through all this that, you know, that touches all the tiles sort of thing. There's a 93 there, really. Mm-hmm. I get around it. There's a C9 over there. That's nice. Let's go fight this battle. Level ourselves up. And I immediately get Malifluxed. Neat. Yeah, because this is attacking both at once, this is the way. Drawing prime. Miss! Haha! None of us have prime numbers. Our levels. Nope. We have three even numbers and level 33, which is not a prime number. Ah. Alright, cool. So I'm gonna grab that square. So we have a 44, or we have a 93 over there, which is sort of annoying. I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fight as many enemies as I can. Oh, that's annoying. Alright, how do I want to approach this? Oh, and you're gonna Malaflux on me. Okay. That's fine. Wow. Not great. Nullify. Miss. Nice. Alright, so I can take out this wizard. Good. Okay. Right, I forgot. Our characters are, like, actually quite fast now. That's helpful. Okay, so now I can do that. Alright. That's gonna be the way to do this. Alright, that's gonna miss. That's good. Alright, now I think I can Maliar and be good. Yeah, okay. Because that will drop us to below, that'll drop the Scorpions to below 920, and Alva can take it from there. Nice. Cool. Mystery Compound D, and Nalperna gains a level. Nice, okay, beautiful. Hey, an ability point, neat. Okay, it's a lot of flying enemies. How do I want to approach this? Let's see. A couple different options here, actually. Actually, despite the defense, I think this is the way to go. Just because there's four, so. Okay, and then two more attacks and we'll be good. Oh, is that? Okay, good. That was physical damage. Good. Alright, we're good. Yeah, Maliar 3, actually very good. Alright, let's go this way. Let's check out what this C9 is. This is, I believe, going to be, what is this? Notes on Fiends, Death Tarot. Okay. What do we got? They first show up on battle 45. They drop a lead armlet. Neat. Okay. That's cool. Alright. Over here, grab this. Oh man, okay. Wow. This is certainly a thing. Let's do this. Okay. Oh, you actually got the attack off first. Okay, because you're also pretty fast. That's fine then. Yeah, that's... Alright, sure. So there it is. Ow. What do I want to do here? Oh, Fluxar, that's fine. Ow, okay, that's less fine. Answer's fine. Malaflux, no, please don't. Ow, okay. Mm-hmm. I'm going to try to withdraw from this battle. Party was unable to withdraw. That's not great. Try it again. Party withdrew from battle. There we go. Okay. I do need to remember to actually resurrect Nalperna. Actually, I can just go back to the Metropolis and resurrect there. That's the play here. Duh. Where is the Metropolis? There it is. Okay. There's a Resurrection Shrine right here. Aha! Okay. Okay. So, now what? We still have the 93 over here. Alright, I can go up this way, though. Up and around. Let's start mapping this out. Alright, there's the stairs down. That's good. So the stairs down are at, let's see, 1266. Okay. No, let's map all this where we can. There are also a lot of places here where you can shift if you so choose. I don't think I'm going to actually find any wanderers for the next several floors, but. I'm not planning on shifting right now, that's fine. I'm going this way. It is, you know, way to go. Both figuratively and literally. Okay, let's come down here. Alright, let's see if we can do any better here. It's Maliar time. So it's gonna take out everything but the Chimera. Manzar is fast. I don't think she's quite that fast, though. Nope, that's fine. And that will take this out. Boom! Alright. Got there. We got 500 gold. And then we got even 8 more. I actually don't think it matters what order we do this in for one scorpion. If we go physical or magic, it's gonna kind of come out in the wash. The only problem here is this. I need a okay roll here. Good enough. All right, at about a 3 in 4 chance of that working, we got there. Someone presumably at kind of like the top right corner of this. Alright, so this should end up at 969 out of 970. I should have just that one tile with the battle 93 that I need to shift away. That one right there. 968. Uh-oh. Well, that's not great. Okay. Oh, well, okay, first things first, let's, Feet and Shuffle. See ya. Okay, so that gave us a battle 45 up here. That's fine, I can live with that. Have to survive one Chimera attack. Confiscate, excuse me. No. Do not agree, video game. By the way, I don't know if you can hear it in the background, but I do have my laundry running, so. Yes, insert, you should go out and catch a joke here. So. That can't be it. Okay. So. Alright, descending stairs. Yep, there's the stairs. Cool. Alright, now I gotta find the one square that I didn't get on this floor. That's gonna be exciting. Alright, there's battle 43. That's not the square, though. This is just me fighting. Oh boy, okay. Okay. Oh, this is where we go. Malaflux. And the other one's gonna malaflux us as well. Okay, that's fine. Alright, just have to survive one set of quad rakes. Beautiful. Bye, Mario. Bye, Mario. You are not currently on camera, so you know. Mystery Compound A. And Elva gains a level. Excellent. Alright. Let's get our abilities back. Bye. Bye. Going down. Okay, so with that, let's see. Let's heal. And then from there, let's see. Can we. Is there an easy way to find the box I've not stepped on? I don't think there is. Mario's like, I found the box I didn't step on. Here we go. I actually thought I had seen it pretty early on here. Yeah. It's not a. Not like down here, right? Oh, there it is. I see it. Down in the left corner there. Boom. Okay. No? You know, I thought it was over there. It's not. Shoot. Alright. Okay. I don't want to do this. Well, Maliar. Oh, that's a problem. Ow. Alright, yep. See, that's the problem here. They do that. And now Elva's gonna eat a bunch of damage because of my idiocy. Okay. Okay. Alright, now I can. Now I can. Not Malaflux, what is it? Maliar, to my heart's content. Store Elva's HP here. Okay. Yeah, that'll work. Cool. Alright. We got there. Not the most elegant way, but we got there. So now, where is this last stupid square we didn't get? It's not there. There it is. Boop. Alright. 3 ability points. Great. I'm gonna go this way, and I'm just gonna shift over there. I think. Well, okay, that was the wrong choice. But shouldn't matter? It did not matter. Okay, good. We got there. Do, 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 do. Do, do, do. Alright, so another 286 gold and another. Shift over here. Alright, so let's see. Do I have anything I can put on right now? I do not. Okay. So I'm missing the strengths and the rejuvenations. Alrighty, cool. That's fine. Alright. Also, I know that Fiend Shuffle seems to just completely shuffle all of the fiends. Like, it restores them to the floor, it almost looks like. All right. Okay, let's not be stupid this time. Let's use the physical attacks. There we go. Got it. Okay. Okay. War 28. So 1266. 1,105 squares to get on this floor. Okay. So I should. Should kind of be keeping an eye out for what is potential. What is this? Can I get over there? I can. Well, I mean, I can. Like, there's a way there. Is there another better way there, is my question. Yes, I should be asking. Also, let me go grab these little shoots here. Can't tell if I actually got this little square up here. I think I did. There we go. Okay. Now I definitely did. Yeah, that is definitely one of the issues with this. And again, it seems like it's kind of by design. But, uh-oh, this is chunky. Speed 85, gonna get there in time. I don't think it is. Nope. That's fine. Alright, cool. Only are three. Alright, the party was victorious. Excellent. Yo, level ups, let's go. Radovich and Mainazar, big level ups. Now Perna, also leveling up. Beautiful, you'd love to see it. Love to see it, folks. Let's grab this loop. I'm thinking of it. Up here, up here. Is this loop off? Interesting. Stairs leading up there. Alternate stairs leading up. Okay. Let's shift over there. Is that gonna take me right back to town, though? Okay, I bet that's what that's all about. Let's maybe not do that yet? Hold off on that for now. With the knowledge I will probably have to do it eventually, or that I would like to do it eventually. Because I got all the squares on the previous floor. So I'm not missing any. I think the only place that can't lead is back to town. Treasure 4. The party obtained a gauntlet. Okay. Let's take a look at what we got here. Alright, so gauntlet. I'm guessing that's one of these. Gauntlet. Increases critical hit rate. Ah, okay. Alright. Well, that's cool, but. Necessarily want it just yet. In the meantime, let's continue exploring this, shall we? Serious battle 46, 46, and 47. Ooh, okay. Off battle. Let's go. That's a lot of bone dragons. We're gonna Maliar this stalker out of existence. We're gonna eat 8 now off Luxar, that's not great. Bone dragons are chunky, but the good news is they don't have a lot of hit points. In fact, they have 1 hit point. If I could find a way to, if I could find an attack that would let me target hit points directly, that'd be awesome. But, as it is, we're okay. Galia, I got a headset. Okay. What does that do for us? Tricorn. Alright, so I imagine it's gonna be a lot of magic defense? Yeah, a lot of magic defense. The problem is that it drops our speed down by, let's see, 4. But,460. Alright, because you actually have a pretty small amount of... I'm gonna give you Galia. Alright, there we go. Because you're still... The 81 is still quite fast. Probably gonna have to eat a couple attacks from this. Oh, nope, because 89 is really fast. Okay, cool. So it's something to keep in mind as well. Is that speed is really good in this game. Wait, Mystery Compound D, okay. Oh boy, battle 4A, you say. Alright. Notes on Fiends. Professor Cavi, what is this? It's a, like, capybara. Oh, okay. Let's battle FD. Alright. Does not drop anything, apparently. Okay. Gives 40, gives 0 experience and 1 gold. What is this all about? Okay. I am very intrigued. Alright, battle 47, what do we got? We have a Chimera, alright. Easy battle, alright. For A, enemy ops not to show up. Okay. I am alright with that. Thank you, video game. Okay, so yeah, here's floor 2 again. This is, again, just some random stairs leading up that I can just go to whenever I want, which is a little disconcerting. Ascending stairs. I'm going to not take those ascending stairs yet. I think I wrote down these coordinates, did I not? No, I didn't. Okay, 48, 46. Because there's not really a place for them to go to that I haven't been already, so I want to see if I can find the next teleporter first. That's going to be the play here. We're going to be able to take out the scorpions, which is really nice. We'll probably have to eat a bone dragon attack. Alperno's faster than the bone dragon, but I don't think, I didn't think it was that much faster. Oh, wait a minute. Why are these still alive? Oh, because, okay. They have 8. Okay, that's fine. In the end, it doesn't matter. Took them out anyway. Alright, so. About half the floor so far. Down here. Flying, flying, reflected, reflected. Really? Ugh. This is where single target magic would actually come in kind of handy. Okay. So let's see. I can quickly take this out, so let's do that. Nullify. Okay, ATB. And Malaflux on Alva. Okay, now what do I want to do? Alright, yeah, I'll do that. Oh, that was actually kind of helpful. Let's take out the Chimera, because I can do that. I get the most bang for my buck out of that with that, and then I can still take out the Chimera. Okay. Well, that's gonna be annoying. Ow. Okay, would really appreciate you not doing that. Okay. Alright, gun time. Boom. Alright. Now we need two shots, and we should... Alright, looks good. Great, wonderful. Alright. Alright, one ability point has been awarded. Neat. Alright, there's the stairs down. 429. We're not even particularly close to being done with exploring this floor, however. 8426, okay. Descending stairs. Well, not more descending stairs. It's the same descending stairs as before. Okay. Battle 47. Yeah. This is how we do this. Confiscate. Excuse me. Do not agree. Yeah. Okay. Actually, I think even though I could target everything, I actually think just going, I think just doing this is the play. 8? Really? Really. I think I do that, and then I do, let's see. Yeah, I think I do that. Alright. That way I only have to survive one attack. Still don't know what Confiscate does. The only thing I'm gonna like it, whatever it is. My shot. Alright. Party was victorious. We got 226 experience and a level. Actually, like, sort of pay attention to where the nearest wanderer is. Alright, flying. Ow, again. The party's double-breasted coat has been broken. Oh, good. Alright, so you just have no physical defense whatsoever. Great. Well, I'll need to put something on there, then. A some more time there, I think. Okay. Who do I Scorpius Bow here? Scorpius Bow you. Okay. No, Quaxar, that's fine. That's actually probably what I want there. Okay, well, now Manazar has no defense whatsoever. This is not ideal. Yeah, I should be able to take this out in time. Let's see. Nope. Okay. I tried. The wizard is the bigger deal in the Chimera, despite the fact that now Manazar has no defense whatsoever. Yeah, I'll take out the Chimera too. There we go. Now I just have to deal with the wizard. That could suck for Manazar. Okay, that's fine. I can live with that. Really? Okay. You can see how much I enjoyed that via my journey. Okay. Not bad. Radovich is actually hurting a little, but still is over 1k HP, so. Don't think it's a crisis yet. It is concerning. I won't lie. So no, I'm now getting farther away from. Still about 20-ish tiles we've not done yet. Alright. Flying, flying, flying. Oh, there's a stupid reflected. Okay. Oh, right, I need to equip something on Manazar. Okay, that's that. I wish that was not a thing they could do. It is a thing they can do. I know it's a thing they can do. I wish it was not a thing they could do. Miss! Haha. Chimeras can also confiscate, which is frightening. It's fine. I'll move that. Alright, then we are going to restore Radovich, then we are going to. Okay, and now we are going to win this battle. Boom! Okay. Do do do. We won the fight. All right, so let me actually equip Manazar now with something, armor. But okay, so we have a. All right, I think they had on a double-breasted coat, which is like just a core, but yeah. Just a core, but better defense, okay. Or actually, it was just a core, but yeah, alright, it also gave speed, right? For now, okay. Alright, so I'm missing 14 tiles. So there's a path somewhere I never explored. Oh, there it is, okay. Well, there's one of them. Alright, that's hopefully one of them? Yeah! Fully charting floor 20. Have been awarded. UDA. So 25. So now I just have to remember where. Alright, it was 84, 26. So I am going way back the wrong way. I'm actually in the right general vertical area. My horizontal, though, is way off. Down here, roughly. Yep, there it is. Okay. Okay, alright, so here we have 84, 26, and a battle 64, okay. I don't know that I want to fight battle 64, quite honestly. In fact, let me go a step further. I know I don't want to fight Battle 64, quite honestly. tiles to get through here. We are going to not get all of them right away, because Battle 64, there's another Battle 64 that is guarding up number, white tile number 23, whatever that means. Okay, well, really? Okay. Hope for a good roll. Good enough. Okay, cool. Lasers. Ow. Snakehead. That's fine. Melofluxar is less fine, considering that two of my characters have... Yeah, okay. Let me take this out. Let's do that. Some more time. Alright, we might be able to take this out before an attack. Might get there. Yes, okay, cool. Launch, that's fine. Okay, so we can do this. Alright. Wow, okay. Oh, and of course, that's so annoying. Restore Manazar's HP, that should still work. Okay. I have obtained a Galia. Okay. So I do need to be careful here. I want to shift this way. Not fight that. I grab this 23. Math Riddle 4, oh boy. The answer is the address. F plus L plus O equals A. S plus O plus U equals B. E plus A plus S equals C. Okay? So hopefully. So if we assume this is like an A equals 1, B equals 2, right? So that would be 6 plus 12 plus, let me think, I believe that's 15. So A would be 33. S plus O plus U. All right, hold on. So P, Q, R, S would be 19. T, U would be 21. So 40, 55 would be the B coordinate. Okay. E, Y, if you will. E plus A is F. That's 6. Plus 19 is 25. All right. So it should be 33, 55, 25, if my presumption is correct. And it may not be. We shall see. All right. Unfortunately, I do have to do something about this 64. Let's shift this way. This. Thank you. Alright, there we go. That one was easy. I hope all the 48s are that easy. I doubt they will be, but I hope they are. So, there's that. Lead armlet. Hey, there's that lead armlet. Also, Roger, I just gained a level. Alright, so lead armlet does what exactly? It's an accessory of some kind. Lead armlets. Increases physical defense by kind of a lot. Okay. That would be the opposite of the approach boots. So, right now, I would say not super useful on this party. I am right now quite enjoying... Right now, I'm quite enjoying my current rollout, where just everybody kind of outspeeds everything, in addition to... I would say it doesn't actually matter what I do here, but it does, because Nalperna's going next, so... Actually, it doesn't. The only difference is we'll just take 3 attacks or 4. I can guarantee 3 if I do this. Might take 4 if I go the other way, because the gun is random, as we know. Okay. Oh. Drawing prime. Missed. Haha. How do we want to do this? Yeah, okay. We're gonna have to survive a couple rounds here, but that's okay. I think we can do it. Not a huge fan of that Malaflux, if I'm being honest, but that's alright. And Nalperna should be able to get there. Cool. Alright. Yeah, so this loadout is not great for enemies that can reflect magic. Yeah, Zargain's a level. What does the Quaff do? Oh, hi, okay. Yes, we want to give you more speed plus that, okay. Yeah. Now have 2 Gallias, alright. 2 Gallia? I don't know. I don't know what the plural of Gallia is. It's fine. This is a rather large floor. I mean, that's obvious, but... Alright, I'm back over here. Alright, so there are 2 squares I have not done yet because they have 64 enemies on them. Alright. Let's do this. Let's go up here. See, like, this is a terrible battle for me. What do I want to do here? Ow! Nice counter. Okay. And lasers, okay. You know what? Here's what we're gonna do. Is this actually the smart way to go about this? I don't know. But we're gonna do it this way. It was smart enough. Let's put it that way. So I can Scorpius bow, let's see. I don't know if it really matters what I get from here, I think. Okay, well, that's actually fine. Alright, so you do that, and then Elva finishes the Chimera. Alright, we got there. Alright, beautiful. Be in there. There's a random 7A over there. Interesting. Okay. How do we get there? worry about that as I get over there, I guess. Right now, we still have a lot of this floor to explore. So right now, there are two squares we have not and cannot get to fairly early on in the floor. The reason we cannot get to those is because, hey, one ability point has been awarded. The reason we can't get to those yet is that we have, 0C. Alright, that's what we were looking for before. Seven A there. Okay. So the way there is not there. Got it. Okay. Here. I mean, it looks like the obvious way over there is from here, but I don't think it's going to be that easy. Over there either. Okay. Unless there's maybe like a double shift I can get later on that will allow me to just sort of instantly go over there. Not appear to be it. Okay. Grab all this. Okay. Hi, you are going to stop, or I'm going to kick you out. You understand? Alright, let's see. Alright, let's battle 49. Have we fought battle 49 yet? I don't think we have. Okay. We have not, and right now we will not. We're withdrawing from this. Nope. Nope, I want no part of that. I will hopefully get to that at a later time. That time is not now. Not until I get some stronger physical weapons, or maybe one of those, like, spears that can attack everything. No, we're not dealing with four witches. Just no. Or wizards, whichever one that was. Point being, we're not dealing with it. Ain't happening. Okay. Anyway, let's keep going here. Alperno's fast. Love it. $536 gold. That is a lot of gold. Do 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 do. Alright, so get in that loop. Oh yeah, I need to kind of be checking to see if I can. Hey, there we go. Exploration ability. Expanded awareness. What is this? The number of uncharted tiles in each direction will be displayed. Ooh, okay. I don't know if it's worth dropping one of my passive abilities for yet, but learned and capable. Acquire 20. We have an achievement, folks. You're good at this video game, is what that tells me. Or I'm just persistent. That's also. I prefer to believe it's that I'm good with the video. So. So we need to kind of pay attention to this. Alright, so there's the descending stairs at 3549. More importantly, there's our two-way teleporter, folks. Number three. Let's go. One B. is this? The Gargoyle's Firearms. Ooh, okay. So I can, alright, Gargoyle Firearms here. That is at 1240. Okay. Alright. So there are, in theory, some cool weapons here. The randomness I cannot abide by, I would say, but the idea is cool. I'm glad to know that's there, let's put it that way. I like that the option is there. Probably the best way I can put it. Let's grab some more paths here. That long path over there, alright. So at the end of this, I should have 1,314. It's all of a sudden done. Okay. Minotaur. Oh, okay. What battle was this? Oh, also, it's fast, by the way. I'd like that noted for the record. Speed 100. So, yeah. Wham. Smite. Maybe don't do that? Okay, that's fine. We should be okay here. Knock out this Minotaur. Alright, cool. I don't know if it was like a mini boss or what that was all about, but. Hey, yeah. 1313, so there's one other tile I have missed somewhere. That's great, that's wonderful. Alright, well, let's see if we can see if in the course of trying to uncover some other stuff here, we come across the one tile that we missed. I saw 260 whatever battles, I believe. That means I'm missing one other square somewhere. Because this is the silly undulating sands. I want to fiend shuffle. Oh, alright. So it takes care of that one. Oh, okay, there we go. Alright. 1315, so it was one. Or it was two consecutive tiles there that I missed, one of the two. But there was one. Okay, yep, so now this brings a whole other gang of enemies back, is the problem. Alright. Let's try battle 49. Three, okay. I might be able to do something with three. Let's give it a shot. This is bad. Oh, it's bad. Ow. That's actually fine. That's actually probably about the best possible thing you could have done. Alright. Feeling better about this now. That's not great, but we're okay. Alright, there we go. We have battle 49 in the books. Fortunately, did not get anything from that battle. Okay. Oh, you got the quick Malaflux on off. That's not great. Mario, what did I say? What did you just do? Okay, there we go. So that takes care of two of the things, and then hopefully Radovich will get the... Oh yeah, Radovich got a lot.
Stay there.
So my laundry is going to... Let me think. Yes, I'm going to need to do something with the laundry soon. When that happens, I will also... I'll be taking a break at that point. Mystery compound, the end a quaff. Okay. Straight upgrade, homie. Inspection. Alright, alright, there we go. Fully charting 429. Now let's go to that teleporter. It's up here somewhere, I think. Really? None of us? Okay. Really? Okay. So we've accomplished, I think, our first objective, which was getting to the third teleporter. There's definitely still some things we want to explore here. I'm unsure how I'm going to go about this. Hey, oh, I gained a level. Nice. Alright, this fiend shuffle did not really work out in my favor. That's alright. Oh, that's right, this is this battle. We are withdrawing from this as soon as possible. Nope, we are not fighting that. Absolutely not. Maybe someday. That day is not today. In fact, we're going to shift right here. And from here, we are going to teleport back to town. Party has discovered a two-way portal. Yes. Let's please. Video game? Thank you. Alright, two-way teleporter 3. Awesome. Alright, so let's Adventurer's Rest. Where is 5? There it is. Okay, now... with this, we're going to shuffle our party a bit here at the academy. I should actually, yeah, that's right. That's not recovery. 06 is the recovery. There we go. All right. Now with that, let me check. Okay, let's check the academy. Let's see where everybody is. So there is a. All right. Yep. There's a doggo that we want to grab at 27.91.33. Alright, so I don't know if we're gonna drop Nalperna for now. And sorry Zandra. I know you like struggling working class mom character, but I myself am more partial to not Gracia. I'm partial to gamer kid oblivious to the peril he is in. So I'm gonna roll with that. What do I wanna do now? Let's see. Chimera's Arms. And the other character that I'm going to roll with once we get there is Doggo. It's a dog. How can you not love Doggo? Alright, so what do we got here? Javelin Partisan, Halberd, buy some Scorpius bows. Yeah, okay, so I think we're going to. I have 3 of these. Unfortunately, they're all equipped. So it doesn't... The problem is the game does not distinguish between what you have and what you have equipped, which is actually fairly important. So we're going to grab a couple of those. There goes the laundry buzzer. I am by Malio 5 now. Nice, okay. But I am instead going to purchase a couple... Oh, actually, did I have Scorpius bows already? Maybe it does distinguish between that. Let me see. The other problem is, yeah, you are not actually going to be able to equip this. Okay. Remove that. Okay. And then grab the Scorpius bow. Okay. And then grab... Can you equip Maliar 3? Absolutely cannot equip that. No. Okay, I don't have any Maliar 3s. It says I'm holding a bunch of them. I am not holding any of them. Alright. Interesting. Alright, so... It says I'm holding 2. I have 3... I have 4 equipped. I don't have any that I can put on Gamer Kid here. Unless he just can't... No, because it would still show up in that case. Hey, Luna, how's it going? Alright, I'm a little confused then, I'm not gonna lie. There's 2. Alright, let's buy another one then. Not 6. It's not like I can't afford it, so. A watch streak. Grab your points. Yes, indeed. Oh, you cannot even come close to equipping that. Okay. I could give you that. Let's do this instead, though. Actually, lower your defense. Okay, there we go. I think that's pretty good. Alright. Alright, so, going to go address Mario's litter box. Gonna go take a quick break. Sorry, I know you just dropped in, but I will be back in a moment. I've not done any kind of sorting. I don't know that you even can be. I don't know that you even can sort. Can you? Oh, you could. Okay. It doesn't give you any, like, easy auto-sort, I don't think. Unless I'm missing something, but no, I have not, because... So, I will talk a little bit more about that when I come back. For now, though. Do I want to do that? I think I'm good as far as that goes. Okay. Sorry, I'm muttering to myself about the laundry. Alright, so I'm going to put up the clip show, I'll run a quick ad, and I'm gonna get up, stretch. Recommend you do the same. And sit tight, everybody. Oh, that Zelda hack. Alright. Back. Looks like Mario the Cat, when he jumped up here, tried to run a second 1-minute ad.
Okay. Oh, okay. Listen to that? Okay. So...
Trevor's
song. Okay.
My favorite episode. Sorry.
That's all right. Okay, so we have a couple things we can check out here. We have not many characters now. So anyway, what I was saying, what I was starting to say is, have I sorted folks by usefulness? I have not. Because yes, that is one way to play this. You can metagame it like that, I suppose. And I guess to a degree I am. I've been rotating characters in and out. But so, like, in a normal, like, wizardry game, right? Your characters are blank slates. They are ciphers for you, the player. And one of the things that I find kind of interesting about this game, as contrasted with a wizardry, is that your character roster, they all have their own sort of characterizations and motivations. Mario here is very food motivated. Give me one moment once again, everybody. Okay, here's what we're gonna do, RF. All right. Here's actually what we're gonna do. We are going to briefly pay the cat tax, and then Mario is going to vacate the room, huh? Yeah. Let's put the webcam up. Yeah, here's Mario. There you are, huh? There we go. Yeah. Oh, who's that handsome cat? Yeah. Who's the handsome cat? Oh, are you bored now? You camera shy now? Is that what's going on here? What's going on here? Yeah. Huh. Okay. A Okay, now can you behave, Mario? If you can't behave, I'm gonna go, okay? Alright, so, what I was saying, here, if you go to the academy, or if you actually just hit party composition, you can see all the little characters, they all have their own little profiles, and I think you can sort of project your own personality into the game by virtue of the characters that you pick. So, like, Zandra, who recommended me this game, which I will once again shout out Zandra Vandra. Yep. She has noted that Maynazar was basically one of her main characters, if not her main character, through the whole game, because she really liked this character's backstory. He's like the working class mom going into the labyrinth to try and essentially make a living for herself and her children. Whereas me, I kind of like, I sort of enjoy this, as far as story goes, Radovich's kind of bio here. I like this sort of archetype, the elderly once great, the, you know, the lion in winter, going out for, you know, one last adventure, one last big score, if you like to use, heist movie lingo. You know, the old man going out one last time. You could say 3 days to retirement if you, you're a little more cynical, like your, police movies. And then, similarly with, McCallie, the sort of oblivious gamer who, with the blues, even though it's not exactly the same, does have kind of the gamer aesthetic. If you remember the Burger King Kids Club from the 90s and KidVid, I get vague KidVid vibes from McCallie here. The blue kind of vest. And then, as for Elva, Elva's a beast man, and I just think that's neat. So. And then, the goal here is going to be this. Is going to be... Okay, hold on. The goal is going to be to vacate Mario the Cat. One moment. No Sir Cat yet. When we get to Sir Cat, don't worry, Sir Cat will be going in the party. But Sir Cat, I think, we have a while to go before we get to Sir Cat. Anyway, so the other character that we will be grabbing once we get them is just Doggo. Yep. Yeah, Doggo. So, I can't remember. Have you played this? Sir Cat, yes. Sir Cat will be party goals, don't worry. And then also, Jufrin here. Again, just Sword Doggo. Why not? The bios here for Jufrin and Jorath, I think kind of imply that Jufrin was at one point human and was transformed into a dog, but that's the fourth character we'll be getting, because just again, Doggo is neat. Good Doggo. Okay, we're gonna go actually here, and all right, I sort of have some unfinished business here for me to attend to. So this will also be a good way to get the other characters. Let's check out if I can equip any new abilities. Expanded awareness. Okay, 10. The number of uncharted tiles in each direction will be displayed. That actually seems pretty good, although I don't know that I need it right now, but I'll put it on anyway. All right. Right, you have nothing to speak of there. Okay, so you cannot really do much in this battle, in other words. I suppose. Take this out. Then we can do what? Take out the Stalker. Right, yeah. Yeah, so it's for, like... Yeah, effectively, it's for, oh, I explored all but a few tiles before I had to bail out, and I don't know where to go from here. That's basically what that's for. Yeah. Right, yeah. Right, go on. Yeah, like, I can definitely see where it is useful. I'm just not convinced it is useful to me right at this moment, especially since I've explored all the floors up to this point, except for, I think, 25 I didn't get all of. So my problem is, Nicali is fairly useless against anything that's not a witch, honestly. Yeah. Okay. Yes, I have noticed they do get bigger. It almost sounds like, even though you say you started, it sounds like you're actually farther than me. So, it got to floor 30, so. That is not the way I want to go. Alright. First off, what am I trying to get to here? I'm trying to get to 5918. Okay, so I need to go down some. Down and way to the left. Got it. Still single digits. Okay. Oh, I see. Okay, yeah. The sorting them and comparing them is actually a really good idea. I'm a little annoyed I didn't think about it. Can I? No, that's gonna be one physical, isn't it? If I do that. Oh! Okay. 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 So if you stay unarmed, you do one hit point of damage. Okay. I did not realize that. That is valuable data. That is, yeah, okay. Okay. Did not realize that. There aren't, granting, there aren't a lot of enemies where that is actually useful, but there are some, so. Unfortunately, Mikali is going to be pretty useless here, so. One! Nice, alright, good job. So, the problem is, Mikali is... Mikali actually gained a couple levels there, and I completely missed it. Okay. I think Mikali was level 12 when we started, so. Can I equip you with anything useful here? Not really. Certainly not Maliar 3. Also, I apparently, even Maliar 2 is so far way above. Right. Guess that's the price I pay for giving you decent equipment. Alright. Yep, that's fine. I do need to pay at least a little bit of attention to what I'm doing. Is going to clean up, so. Yeah, and I think not only that, but Elva Elva actually has pretty good hit points, too. Like, Elva is just really good. You can see, yeah, 103 versus 95. Like, I mean, I suppose it makes sense, because Elva, like, Radovich, again, he's sort of the, I wonder, actually, if that's... I wonder sort of if they're, if the character's sort of lots in life are reflected by their stats, if that makes sense. Kind of cool if so. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, I wonder if, you know, right, yeah, if, Elva, Beastman in prime of his life, you know, would naturally just be superior to, Radovich, sort of, like you said, old man, kind of, as I put it, lion in winter. All right, well, McCallie is gaining levels very fast, so that's good. Still not gonna be able to equip anything, I don't think. I could give him Malafluxar 1 if I really want. And that's still not great, but it would be better than nothing, strictly speaking. What else could I do with you? Nope, I can't even do that. I could give you a javelin. Could have you do 60 damage to everybody. I am going the wrong way. Alrighty. I think this is the way I want to go. I'm reading this right. Nope, so inventory sorting you can do automatically. You go into your inventory, and if you look down near the bottom there, Y sort. You just hit that, and it sorts it automatically, which is really nice. So it looks like it goes by sort of weapons, magic, then kind of unique weapons, and armor. And then, helmets, like, stuff that does not increase speed, stuff that does increase speed, and then, like, other stuff. Also, I am still hoarding. Right, yeah, okay. I'll take your word for it. I haven't paid super close attention to how shops sort, but, yeah. That makes sense. I mean, it doesn't really matter what you do, honestly. We'll have you hit that, I suppose. Because we're doing this, so... you have 8 points. Okay. 9. Okay. I mean, that's still not a lot, but... Alright. Yeah, so that's why you'd use that. That's kind of cool. That was actually not the best way to go about this, but that's okay. I don't think it really matters at this point. Because I could have just, I could have just had one kill one and then McCallie directly attack the one hit point. Yep. So, one thing I will say is that there is a reason to not, there is a reason to not necessarily have only everybody Maliar for magic attacks. I'm going to guess you don't care about spoilers, but, you know, if you're here and all. But as you might guess, I don't think you encounter any of them on the single floors, but there are... You will soon find there are reasons you do not want to just attack everything with magic all of the time. what am I doing here? Yep, Wizards Reflect. Yep, I think I might actually still have the ROM equipped now. Okay. Yep, Wizards Reflect, that is correct. You figured it out. Where am I trying to get to? I'm trying to get to 2380. Okay. I go up and right, basically. Okay. this, I guess. So at some point, I found a gem that gives Elva an extra 200 damage as well. Alright. How many levels up? Can I give you anything useful yet? Probably not. I mean, if I feel like rolling the dice on Malaflux 4, I could do that. I still can't quite even equip Maliar 2 yet, which would not be great, but it would most of the time be better than what we're doing. Only the one guy can. Okay, yeah. And as it turns out, unarmed attack attacks hit points, which is really funny that I did not realize that until very recently. Attack the skeleton for one hit point. That's great. Alright, so unfortunately, McKelly not going to be very useful here. Yep, wizards reflect, witches and wizards can reflect. And there is a battle later on that's witches and nothing else. So if you only have magic attacks equipped, you're just kind of screwed. Still going up and right. So it'd be... don't think it actually mattered how I handled this, honestly. As long as I committed to one of physical or magical. Because now I can Scorpius Bow, Scorpius Bow. Whereas before, the other thing, it would have been Maliar 3, Maliar 3. McCallie does nothing, essentially. In that Maliar. So I'm trying to get, like, up right here, I believe, if I'm reading this right. Oh, thank you for the follow. Yep, I'm trying to get over there, okay. Alright, we're just gonna shift to over there. Didn't go quite the right way, but that's alright. So 22, what's on 22? Okay. Nothing on this floor, but there is a healing station on the next floor. And I am trying to get to 91, so I'm trying to go way up and... No, hold on. 2380, 6049. Farm iron? Yeah, okay. So, still trying to go. Where am I? Okay, no, I'm trying to go, let's see, up left? Down left. Yeah, okay, the way this works is, yeah, okay, so down left. Oh, hey, awesome. Well, thanks for stopping by. Hello, hello, and welcome. This is not Final Fantasy Fiesta, but, you know, it's sort of adjacent, I suppose. This, if you don't know, is Dungeon Encounters. 2021 Square Enix game. There is a dungeon. You go through it, you fight encounters. It almost kinda, to me, reads as sort of Square Enix wanting to... do, like, wizardry, even though the perspective is very much not wizardry. I feel like it takes a lot of the concepts and just puts, like, a Square Enix sort of twist on them. Also, one thing that's nice is no random battles. What are we gonna do here? I'm going to attack you and kill you. Because that, the one hit point, it hits hit. That's awesome. I will never stop laughing at that. Okay. So this is going to be this. And then... So, one of the ways in which this is like Wizardry, if you don't know Wizardry, it is a series of dungeon crawling games that was really big in like the 80s in particular. There's actually recently a HD remake of the first one. But anyway, I am going the wrong way. That's awesome. Okay. So, like, attack power, as we think of it in, like, Final Fantasy, is not a thing in Wizardry. Your weapon does damage. In Wizardry, it does a range of damage. And your strength modifies that damage, but there's no, like, attack power stat as such. And similarly, there's also not a defense power stat as such. Your weapon hits, and if it hits, it just does a range of damage. And vice versa. If an enemy hits you, whatever that enemy can do for damage, you are taking that range of damage. So, let's see here. I'm gonna fight this, and I'm gonna come over here and refresh my abilities. Even though I think the only ability I've used is I've shifted hands. That's going to take, okay. Unfortunately, Mikali is useless here. Okay, fine. Sandstorm. So. Yes, thank you, Nightbot. I'm considering changing up that message. You still get the sentiment across, but changing the specific wording some. But in any event, once I get into a battle, I can try and explain the system a little more. Like over here. Okay. So. Okay. Sword, yep, cool. Ow. Okay. And Sonic Pulse is gonna do what? Okay, you're gonna do that. Fine. Okay. So basically, enemies and you have sort of three separate life bars. You have PD, MD, and HP, as you can see there. PD is physical defense. It's defense against physical attacks. MD is magic defense, defense against magical attacks, and HP is your hit points. If your HP goes to zero, you die. Same thing for the enemies. Typically, you have to get through one of the defenses before you can start attacking hit points. And once you do, then you can directly attack hit points. Looks like one exception is if you go unarmed, which does one damage, but it does attack hit points, which is actually really helpful here. Because, what do you know? This skeleton has one hit point. Boom. Warrior Monk. Let's go. Okay, so, let's talk a little bit more about what you see here. So I have one of two attacks I can use. The Scorpius Bow has four symbols. They both have four symbols. I was just trying to refresh my memory on what the symbols actually were. So the first symbol is whether the attack does fixed or variable damage. So these are both fixed damage. You can see the number to the right of all the symbols. So this will do 1100 damage. This will do 720. The second symbol is it a physical or a magical attack? So this is physical, this is magical. That's what that means. Little shield is physical, sort of star is magical. The third symbol is it a melee or a ranged attack? Only ranged attacks can hit flying monsters. You can see the stalker to the top left has flying. So luckily I can hit with both of those. And then the final symbol is it a single target or a multi-target attack? So this here, this Maliar 3, will do 720 magical damage to all enemies. And right now, because the Stalker has no magic defense, that is actually enough to kill the Stalker. Because the Stalker has no magic defense and 660 hit points. And that will also knock out the Worm's defenses. Worm's magic defense. There's no sort of trample, by the way, for your defenses. So even though, so for instance, if I were to Scorpius Bow this Worm, I would take out the one physical defense, and I would just waste the remaining 1,299 damage. The good news is this also goes for enemies, so. Bone sword's ready. You have no magical attack, so you can just punch the skeleton. And we can do this. So right now I'm actually shorthanded, because one of the sort of mechanics of wizardry, and also of this game, hey, level 37, nice. This is the way I want to go, right? I said down left. I wanderer tracking. Oh, well, that's fine. That's... Yes, I can show that off, but I don't think I'm going to be doing much. What does that do? Oh, that's, okay, yeah. So there are attacks that can bypass defense and attack hit points directly as well. These dissolve attacks. Luckily, I've got one too. Right, yes. Good point. Yep. That is a good thing to... is a good thing to bring up. Yep. Iron Armlet. That's cool. So one of the... not expanded awareness. Wanderer tracking. So throughout the dungeon, if I go to party composition, this just tells me the coordinates of where people are. 050/50 is kind of like the home hub. It's like the town hub, the academy. And so I have four characters in my party, and there's this friend. This is the square I'm trying to get to. I'm trying to get to 27-91-33. So I can pick up Jufrin. And then there are a number of other characters that I don't know where in the dungeon they are yet. I have to get to the square they're on and search it, and it'll tell me, hey, good job, and then... So. So that's that system. Yeah, it's pretty neat. The other thing is that I'm pretty sure, because this is wizardry inspired, if I were to die, my characters would just be chilling as corpses down in the dungeon. I'd have to go round up another party to grab them. So, that's another reason you kind of maybe want to rotate your characters in and out. So that if you have to make the rescue expedition, it's not completely terrible. That is not what you would typically do in wizardry. In wizardry, you would just make multiple copies of your characters so that if you stop at a little party kill, you just do that. I have played several wizardry games, if you will, straight, quote unquote. Like, I guess Iron Man is one way you'd put it. If you're familiar with, like, XCOM or, I don't know, other strategy games. Where there is no reloading. I don't recommend it. Where am I trying to get to here? Alright, so 35-33. That is up left. Okay. So, fight some battles. But as I was saying, I think, before you came in here, these... Final Fantasy Tactics is another good one. Fire Emblem, I think, is really kind of a big one. Sort of that space, now that I'm thinking about it. 23. There is healing on this floor, right? Yeah. Let's punch this mummy. And And you basically, much like wizardry, you can gain levels, and that they do help, but what really gets you stronger is your equipment, I would say. In this, even more so than wizardry. Like, I gain levels, and I gain hit points. So actually, this is a good time to talk about it, because Mikali just gained a level. So you can see my max HP went up, and also my max PP went up. PP. Alright. Now that that's out of the way. Your PP stands for proficiency points. That actually governs what and how much equipment you can equip. So, Mikali currently has a Scorpius bow on, and the PP cost on that is 14, so I need 14 proficiency points to equip that. The Tricorn is another 14, and this Carabini Mail is going to be 10, because 14 plus 14 plus 10 is 38. So now I hopefully have enough that I can actually equip you with something useful on the second slot. I mean, not that being able to punch stuff is not useful. I could do that. Yeah, let's do that. There we go. Alright, so now everybody has kind of the same loadout as far as their weapons go. Where am I trying to get to? I'm gonna go up left, I think. Yeah, okay. Actually in approximately the right place as far as up goes. So. Alright, this is gonna kill two sharks. I am gonna have to eat an attack from this hellhound. That's okay. Now a flux is fine. Now Flux targets magic, and we have a lot of magic defense. Two chainmails, okay. Chainmail is not going to be that useful, I don't think. It's as good as... Oh, okay. I stand corrected. Alright. Let's see. What do we do with that? Problem, I really like how fast Radovich is. So yeah, I think we're gonna do this. I'm gonna give you the chainmail. There we go. Oh, there's an F9 battle here, which I did write down. This is a thing here. I'm gonna shift here. Also, as you wander the dungeon, you will acquire passive abilities. So one of them is this, or you'll acquire, like, sort of... how do I explain it? Having trouble here. But essentially, you will acquire abilities that are like, oh, you know what? I could have attacked him. Just that. Just playing. I lost my train of thought. I'm just gonna score these bow this because I can do that. Ow. Really? Okay, well, you're probably dead. Yep. Okay, good news is I have a way out of this. Bad news is I want to try to get... alright, so that's cool. That's fine. Feral Fangs. Oh, that actually hit. Okay. I did not do what I thought it was going to do. Luckily, I have a certain amount of resurrection abilities I can use, so let's do that. And I just hope he doesn't target... Okay, that's fine. What am I going to do here? I want to use the other ability. I want to restore Kelly's hit points. Nope. Also, you will notice, so there are, as you can see, there are revive abilities that you get a certain amount of, and on certain floors of the dungeon, you can replenish your abilities. But there are no potions as such. There's no, like, healing out of battle, really, as far as I can tell. Also, one thing you will notice, the scaling is very, very exponential. You can see Mikali gained about 100 hit points, going from 21 to 22, and Radovich gained, like, 300, going from 37 to 38. So... battle F9 is not a battle I want to mess with right now, as I mentioned before. There is healing over here, but maybe not. Yeah. So yeah, it kind of does force you to... I guess think about it is how I would phrase it. Sort of forces you to really consider carefully how you plan to do things. So the horror hands are flying, but luckily we all have Scorpius bows equipped, so attack them. Physical attacks. Yep. Ooh, Malaflux 5. Although actually I think I have Malaflux 6 if I really feel like rolling the dice. Yeah, alright. Sort. Yeah, so I mentioned that, so this you'll see deals a random amount of magical damage. Again, attack power is not a thing, so offense here is the maximum value that it can do. The minimum for all of these, by the way, alright, so the maximum here is 70 damage, the minimum is 1. The maximum here is 230 damage, the minimum is 1. Maximum here, 550, the minimum is, would you like to guess? Did you say 1? You are correct. So you are really rolling the dice if you opt to use a magical damage attack. The sort of upside to the random damage attacks is that they tend to be, not that gold as a resource has really been a problem for me in this playthrough, but they tend to be cheaper to purchase than the fixed damage attacks. And the other thing is they do tend to be, I don't know if it's necessarily stronger, but the maximum tends to be higher on the random damage stuff you acquire at a given point in the game than the corresponding fixed damage. So you can see I just got Malaflux 5. Which is 2,000 on the max end. And so far the highest single target fixed thing I found is Malio 4, which is 700. So if I feel like, you know, if I feel like gambling on a single target random spell versus single target physical spell, actually, I think I could have bought Malio 5 if I really wanted to in the store, and I didn't. But you can see I still have about a 2 in 3 chance of this being the better attack. So, I'll go fight this before I get to 423. Yep. And then there are also guns, which is kind of funny. The guns are the attack all random physical damage. Usually. At least one shark is gonna get to attack. Ooh, that's not great. Okay. 08. This is a Gorgon altar. That will unpetrify a character on a given square. But I think I am immune to petrification right now, so I don't... alright, so we're on floor 24. 35, 33, so I need to go down right, basically. Okay. Even your speed is not level influenced. Some of your equipment gives you more speed. There's equipment that only gives you speed, and there's equipment that also gives you speed and defense. So this tricorn gives me magical defense and speed. This gives me physical defense and speed. So this is why Radovich is kind of fast. So Radovich is fast in part because he also has these boots, which increase his speed. Time to stretch. Also, this is actually taking a bit longer than I expected, so, but that's okay. I am 3 floors away from my objective now.
I say it was going up and right.
I'm going this way, I think. I want to go down from here. Okay. No, 3E. Shark attack? Please no. Wow, okay. Not gonna lie, suddenly feeling pretty good about that, Should be able to get 2 off here. Wow. Okay. Alright. Cool. Ouch. That's fine. Right, okay. Yes. In any event, that's how that works. So, but yeah, this is, thank you for stopping by. Appreciate it. Hey, new normal, cool. Yeah, I am so far really liking this game. Hey, what's up, Meta Sigma? How's it going? Yeah, I have definitely enjoyed this. I have to get over there. There's a lot of horror fans. Oh, nice. Okay, cool. Yeah, so, like I said, Xandra recommended this to me. She was quite emphatic about recommending it to me, in fact. She was like, you specifically need to play Dungeon Encounters. So, she was correct. But yeah, this has been fun. Right now, I am just trying to sort of mop up some of the earlier floors, which is why I'm rocking 3 characters. I'm going to get a 4th Wolf Void, is the goal here. Speaking of guns. So this is the random damage all physical. Random damage physical attacks all. Where is it? There it is. And do up to 1,000 damage to all enemies. I feel like rolling the dice on that. Okay. Nice block. Yeah. Probably farther than me, yeah. Yeah, it is a lot of fun. I've been trying to only play it on stream, is the thing, so. Maybe don't eat me, thanks. Don't dissolve my hit points, please. Okay. Yes, I do also do music stuff. I play around with Family Tracker. So, add that there as well. Okay, let's go down to floor 25. Alright, so I didn't actually... There's actually a few tiles. Okay, so this is where I'm going to put in another ability here. There are 6 tiles that I never... Okay, so there are 4 to my west here. Right, because there were... This had, yeah, okay. Yep. Right, because this had the super enemies there. That's right, yeah. I remember now. I would like to get over there if I can. It had the, like, 94 enemies. So the number of the enemy is a... The number of the battle, I should say, is, I would say, roughly a proxy for how difficult it is. So that's why there were some squares here I didn't get to, because I was like, oh, I don't... this one has, yeah, this has, like, battle number 94, which I don't think I'm strong enough. Well, I'm definitely not strong enough with three characters, let's put it that way. But, hey, levels, cool. That was a terrible level up for McCallie. It was a very good level up for Elva. That was, Luna, that was for you. That was a wizardry level up we just saw there. You gained one hit point! Doodly-doo! Oh boy. Alright. Yep, that was a one hit point level up, folks. Alright, what am I looking for here? Hold on. Throw this back on. That's right, one of the things I'm supposed to be doing is searching for tiles that I've not hit yet. Yeah. Yeah, it's true. I should, yeah. It is something you can do, yeah. Yeah, I'll do this. It's fine. Ow. Okay, we were going to withdraw from this battle. The party was unable to withdraw. Well, that's bad. Party withdrew from that. Okay, I need to be careful here. I know what I want to do. Nope, not that. That was not what I wanted to do. That was emphatically not what I wanted to do. Lesser Ascend, please. Alright, well. As a positive side effect, that does get the... I did get the encounter I was worried about. Where is the... I know there's healing on this floor. I know, because I wrote it down. 59, 47. So I need to go down some more. Alright. Down here, roughly. Alright. Yeah. There it is. Got it. Russian Shrine. Healing Fountain. And Purification Spray. Alright. That's not the way. Right, I'm still looking for two tiles. That was, again, part of the reason I was here. Do I want to do that now? Or do I? I'll look around for a little bit, yeah. The other problem is, because this is the undulating sands, it is actually really hard to tell when you haven't hit something. Oh! One south. One south. This is not a drill. So yeah, hey, remember when I was like, yeah, I don't know if this is going to be immediately useful. I was wrong. Now. To find the other one. Okay. Yeah. So now my issue is I'm trying to, like, simultaneously sort of scan for, like, a square that looks transparent while simultaneously checking. Simultaneously checking around here to see if expanded awareness goes off. It's actually surprisingly tricky to do. Oh! West, one. Okay. This way. West, one, what? Okay. That made a lot of sense, but okay. Really? North one. Ooh, sneaky. Okay. Boy, it is a good thing I decided to not do this floor. Wow. That's what I thought, okay. Reduced galleys hit points to one. Alright, we need to do something about that. Where are we going from here? Alright, we're trying to go way down and slightly to the left. Okay. There's lesser descend, I wonder. Fight some battles. I probably could have waited a little bit. Oh, right, okay. The one that has a yes, okay. Alright, got a bunch of gold. Yes, that's lesser descension, and all right, to go slightly down and way to the left. Okay. Ooh, waffles, yum. Take out the gargoyles. That sucks. Okay. Luckily, still have over 1500 HP, so whatever. Claw rig. Okay. And dead. Cool. Alright, so on this floor is what I call a metropolis. Like, way down here. There it is. It's basically where you can rest and recover all of your abilities. Grab an ability shrine here. Strength. Is there anything I can equip here? Not really. I will use the healing fountain, though. So let's see. Yeah, so I could buy Malio 5. You can see, so there's Malio 5, which does a fixed amount of 1,250 damage to a single target. And then there's Malaflux 5, which is both cheaper and does more damage. Yes, you can buy items at the Metropolis. That's part of why I call it the Metropolis. So you can always buy items sort of in the town, in the academy, on floor zero. And then you will sort of, I won't say randomly, but occasionally you'll come across these, like, sort of major, come across these things where, Luna, by the way, you can hit L and R, to see who can equip stuff, when you have it kind of highlighted. So there are, looks like there are two other characters who can equip the ROM. And then, I could buy Fluorite. There's more of these than that. Okay. Ring. There's a lot of physical defense. Is there anything that's going to be really useful here? I mean, maybe. Right, yeah. Yeah. Because I got an item where I was like, why can't I equip this? And Xandra was like, hey, have you tried looking at your party in the inventory screen? I was like, oh, okay. Baleful Breath. Now our Okay. Lowered our defenses pretty severely here. What do I do here? This is going to attack first, so let's take care of it. I don't think we're going to be able to outspeed the gargoyle here, but maybe. Well, we'll get one attack. I don't think we'll get two. Yeah. Right, yeah. Yeah, I will say some of the enemies in this are they're very well tuned to sort of to have stats that are like super annoying just to require that one extra hit. It is actually kind of irritating at times, but hey, McCallie gains a level. There we go, that's a good level. About 150 HP. I'm gonna actually shift back over here and recover. I also want the Adventurer's Rest. So also, every code is kind of the same. So if I see a 06 somewhere, that's gonna be a healing. So you can see these are physical evasion. You have a chance to just outright block attacks, magical attacks. It's kind of neat. That's the way you want to go. So these hats, they give these give defense plus speed. And then these give defense but not speed. Oh no, I'm sorry. These, okay. These are coats. These give physical defense plus speed. There's a separate armor shop. Is it this one? It's this one, right. These give you more defense, but they don't give you speed bonuses, so. So I can get 65,400 physical defense. Oh, okay, that actually does give you speed. Interesting. Okay. Some of them do. These give you way more. They give you more speed at the cost of some physical defense, in that case. Yeah. Alright, so with that, I'm gonna go fight this, and then I'm gonna go actually do what I came here to do. This is just annoying. No matter what, this is just going to take a bunch of attacks. There's nothing I can do. Just have to suck it up and go to it. It's going to take out the killer chair. We're going to have to eat at least one, probably two more attacks. Baleful Breath. Ow. Okay. Well, that sucked for Elva. Good thing Elva is a freaking tank. Let's go back and heal again, shall we? So the square I'm trying to get to is, I actually did write it down. 91.33, so I need to go way down and then slightly over. Down here. So this is one where the Maliar comes in really handy. But yeah, so I'm happy that other people have gotten into this game thanks to me, in turn thanks to Xandra. So Xandra's really the one to thank. Alright, and this will kill all of them. Great. Boom. Alright. Radovich gaining a level. It's over here. It's 91. This one. Yep. Oh, right. I discovered them, so I can just add them to the party now that I'm on the square. Yes, got it. Alright. Welcome to the party, doggo! I just think it's neat. So he has a weapon, Fragrak. Fragrak! Let's take a look at that. First thing I'm going to do is I don't know that it actually matters, but I'm going to swap those two. Swap these two as well. Olva has actually outclassed Radovich in HP. So, alright, that is a single target physical attack, but it does a whole lot of damage. So yeah, we like that. Speed, nice, okay. What do I want to give you here? Do I have another Maliar 3? I don't. I could go buy one. But I am not going to do that. I'm going to do this instead. Okay, so first off, let's give you hat. So the hats are magic defense. The armor is physical defense, and then you have your sort of accessory. I'll do that for now. What else will we do here? Do that. That's not gonna. No, you know what? I'm gonna give you the weaker one, I think. Alright, and then we're gonna. There's my beast man running around. Check him out. So I can just Adventurer's Rest here and get that shift right back. So what I want to do is this. Nope, not Skeleton's Defense, not Mummy's Guard. Wizard's Incantations, there we go. 14, okay. Buy one of those, alright. I'm probably not going to be able to equip that, am I? No, I can't even equip that, okay. I don't want to get rid of this, but I think I have to for now. Alright. Alright, there we go. Alright, yeah, I like that, I think. Yeah, alright. Where's my lesser dissension? No tile directly below. All right. Where is the 1266? Sorry, I have to go way the heck up. Fine. I'm in roughly the right area. X-wise. Should go way up. There's battle 93. We're gonna not mess with battle 93. Ow. Okay. Really? Okay. I guess we just do that. That will actually help. We can undo that, and we can kill that one. And... Oh, that did not kill. Okay. Luckily, we are quite fast. So, we can just do this. We can just do it again. It's fine. 74 is my slowest speed. Pretty good. Okay, there was... Oh, right, there was a separate... Yeah, okay. Yeah, so here you can see the wizards, they can reflect. So, hitting them... Hitting them with magic would be a really bad idea. Let's see. It wasn't the ideal way to do that, but okay. Oh, really? Huh. Okay. I think I reflected once, and I was just like, I don't feel like dealing with that, so. Okay. Learned that the hard way? Okay. That's good to know. Yeah, because I think I threw one spell at them, and then I was like, oh, I didn't mean to do that. And I just never tried it again. Maybe I should have. Okay. Good data. I will say, just as a general note, please try to avoid hints slash spoilers, etc. But... what are we gonna do here? Yeah. Yeah. 2400 damage strike, let's go. Let's go, doggo. I don't want to do this now. I think this is actually still faster. Nope. Doesn't matter. I think it's gonna be six attacks either way. With the exception being that Jufrin can't actually get this, so. Guess I'll just do that. Drop that part. Ooh! No, please don't confiscate my stuff. Do not approve. Alright, we're in there. Party was victorious! Ooh, Pickle Halb. Malaflux 6, and Mikali gains a level. Nice. So what is a Pickle Halb? Don't get the speed, but that is a lot of magic defense. Okay. I don't particularly like lowering Mikali's speed, but that's just so much extra magic defense on what is the weakest character in the party that I think I've got to do it. Alright, where am I trying to get to? 4846, okay. Thank you. Maybe that one. Okay, it takes out that scorpion, which is nice, okay. Or you mouthwatch the person who has absolute tank defense. Stop. That's nice. And of course, Jufern is going to be the one who attacks first. Oh no, okay. Mikali got there. There we go. Hit them with one weak spell, okay. That's good to know, but at the same time, I don't know that that's really that... I don't think it's worth keeping a weak spell around just for that. I'm going to fight this, and I'm going to go up these stairs, which I'm pretty sure are going to take me back directly back to town. I don't want to do this. Yeah, of course, okay. Of course. That's absolutely not the way to do it, but... Okay, Do it. Okay. That attack is so annoying. Confiscate just breaks a piece of equipment that you have on. You cannot actually do anything here. Alright. Let's do that, I guess. I don't know if that was actually the way to go about this, but whatever. That'll work out. Get it down to 1227, and Jufern can do, I believe, 1250. Yes. Nice. Okay. Sometimes it's almost like I know what I'm doing tactics-wise. Not always, but sometimes. Alright, let's take these stairs. Let's see if they go where I expect them to. Oh no, okay, they just took me back up to the Metropolis. Very interesting. Okay, so there are one-way stairs to the Metropolis. Weird. Alright. Alright, well. Nothing else. I know I can lesser descend right there. Can I do it again? Can. Right into a 64 almost. Let's maybe not hit that. And there's our teleporter back to town. Alright, cool. Alright, beautiful. Alright, beautiful. So yeah, actually... Someone did give me a good idea here to check some of these battles. See if maybe I've seen them already. See how strong they are or are not. Gotten up to. Alright, so the first one is 5A. I think that's one I've seen. Yeah, that's one I've seen on floor 17. That's a little chunky. Okay. We got witches. Okay. And then a mystery third enemy we've not gotten the data for yet. Next one is 70. A monk. Level 47 monk. Okay. That's all they have? I might be able to handle that. Somewhere down here we have. I already know DE is like ouch. Because I fought that one time. Yeah, level 89 ghost, right. That's right. What else? There is F9. I've not even seen what that is yet. Technically, I have won a battle against a treasure hunter. Mystery Compound E. Interesting. shop wares. Okay, so when you... Okay, I see. Shopwares. So when you beat an enemy, in addition to dropping, it has a chance of that item being available for purchase at a shop. Is that what's going on there? I just noticed there were, like, two different sort of drop tables there. Okay. All right, anyway, 94 was another one. Yeah, okay. I sort of kind of figured that out. Gave us full dress. Okay. I don't know that I got the, like, actual... I don't know that I, like, you know, exactly figured that out, but I figured it was... I, like, intuitively, I kind of figured out that it was sort of correlated with how far you'd gotten in the game. Okay. That makes some sense now. All right. I think someone is equipped with the inferior version of the double-breasted coat. Yeah, okay. You are. Okay. Do we have a double-breasted coat? We do not. Okay. So let's buy one. We'll give that to Radovich. Right, okay. Like, I don't think I'm gonna metagame this quite that hard, but that is good to know. That is a thing you can do. I don't need recruit's clothing. Get out of here. I probably don't need a lot of this stuff, honestly. Oh, actually, now that you know, you're still you're not particularly close. So I need to give up some points for that, and I don't want to give up points for that. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I don't think you were here when I noted that I subscribed to the Xandravandra method of hoarding items. Like, why don't I use them? I don't have a good reason for you. This is just what I do in games. But anyway. So we've made it back to town. We completed our objectives for the day, I do believe. So, I am going to, let's see, where is the save and abandon? Not abandoned party. That is absolutely not what I want to do. So this is, I think this is the party we're going to be rocking with for a while. No, I don't want to do that. What am I doing? So let's just take a look at some of the potential characters. Okay, so we have, anime guy. Yep, cool. All right. Okay, witch lady, doggo's brother. We have a robot. Okay, that's interesting. Be fun to find. Okay. So that's, I guess, rival of one of the other characters up here, Renzo. Okay, I'm just taking a quick look at... Okay, Sir Cat is one we're going to want, because cat. I mean, hello. So, all right. So I think our targets now are K2000 and Sir Cat. All right. Cool. All right. So we have... we have Mysterious... we have Dragon, and then we have Everith. Okay. So, Yeah. So as far as, like, personalities go, I was saying earlier that, like, you can sort of project yourself onto some of these characters because they have little bios. And I think, you know, who you pick, if you're not the super ultra metagamey type, sort of tells a lot about you as a person. So, like, Radovich, I mentioned before, he's like the old man going out for one last ride, which is something, you know, that story beat appeals to me. And then Mikali, the kind of oblivious gamer stereotype. You know, obviously that would appeal to, I think, probably a lot of people who would play Dungeon Encounters. And then Elva the Beastman, I just think that's neat. Sword Doggo, again, I just think that's cool. No deeper meaning attached to it. So. But anyway. Okay, with that, that is going to be it for me for tonight. Thank you all for watching. And with that, we have reached the end of stream number 4 for 2024. This is where I say bye, YouTube.